Hello everyone, welcome to this video series where I am going to discuss very briefly, very fast, what are the scholarships that you can get in Netherlands as an international or Indians. So the video has three parts. In the first part, I will go through the different types of scholarships that you can get in Netherlands, the in general overview. In the second part of the video, I will discuss about specific university specific scholarships. In the third part of the video, I'll discuss about exclusive scholarships only for Indians, apart from the scholarships that I have mentioned before. So you can browse through all of these scholarships using the timestamps in the video description below. I will also make it scroll through the screen so that it is easier for you. So let's jump into the video. So there is a very beautiful website called studyinholland.nl. The Study in Holland website gives a very nice overview of all the scholarships, like you can see it here. Erasmus Plus Scholarship, Holland Scholarship, MENA Scholarship, NN Future. So these are the list of scholarships that you can get. They have outlined it very nicely. So you can go through that and apply for these scholarships. So I will just briefly highlight some of these scholarships so that you know what you can expect. But I won't explain you, it's redundant, like you can read it from here, everything is there in the links and everything, so I won't explain you how you need to apply. And you can also use their search tab here to search for different scholarships in the home page, because they have outlined it very nicely with the different search terms that you can expect. So let's go through each of the scholarships. Yeah, so first one is the Erasmus Plus scholarships. So it shows that it was valid from 2014 to 2020, but it was not, it will be renewed after 2020. So you can expect this scholarship for traineeship or graduation, bachelor's, master's. I think it was for master's. And you will get all the eligibility criteria, how you can apply, the links and everything is the checklist. So the website is very nice. So I don't want to waste my efforts and your time by going into the details. So one additional thing that I want to mention, that inside Erasmus Plus, there is something called Erasmus Mundus. All these links I will also leave in the description below so that you know what I mean. This Erasmus Mundus, many of my friends in computer science got it. So there are specific programs in masters which are coming under Erasmus Mundus. What it means is that for 1 year, you can do masters in one European country and another year you go to another. For example, one of my friend, 1 year masters in computer science sub faculty he did in UDelft, and the second year was in Sweden. The entire study was fully funded, full scholarship for living and study. And apart from that, you get experience of 2 countries for masters. So it's a very good deal if you want to look for Erasmus Mundus programs. And I'm not sure, you have to look through the details in this website. I think you need some kind of work experience to be sure that you get this scholarship. Otherwise, it's very competitive because it's a full scholarship, so very few people get it. Next in the Study in Holland website is the Holland Scholarship. It is very popular because many people get it, and it gives you around 5,000 euros one time fee. And how you apply, which everything is mentioned here. As far as I remember, it is available for all the countries to apply. Next is MENA Scholarship. So MENA Scholarship, it gives scholarship for professionals for doing short courses. And it's valid for only these countries. So it's not valid. It's valid for Algeria, Egypt, Iran, Iraq, Jordan, Lebanon, Libya, Morocco, Syria, and Tunisia. So I think it's not valid for Indians. Yeah, I will go to that in the third part of the video. What are the exclusive scholarships for Indians? So Orange Knowledge Program, that is the next scholarship, Orange Knowledge Program. This is valid for these countries. There's a huge list of countries. Afghanistan, Albania, Armenia, Bangladesh. You can read all these countries. So this is generally for mid-career professionals and short courses, and also for master's program because they list it here. So that's why I said if you go through these pages, you'll understand everything. I'll just leave the home page link and you can go through them in the description below. Because they have, I was trying to prepare a script for it, but when I saw like this is already too detailed and very nicely structured, then it's much easier to go through them. Why would I waste my efforts to do the same thing again? You understand, right? So how you apply and everything is mentioned here. So you have to go through the details. This is another scholarship for master students or doing short-term courses like 2 weeks to 12 months. Next is Orange Tulip Scholarship. This was going around in Twitter and many social media recently, and it's very popular, it seems. So NESO is like the official website for different countries. They have NESO, NAFIC NESO, which is also with India and other countries. So the Orange Tulip Scholarship is valid for so many countries. Brazil, China, India, Indonesia, Korea, Mexico, Russia, South Africa, Vietnam. So the Sino-Dutch Scholarship, as you can understand from the name, it is a collaboration between China and Netherlands. So every year, 25 Dutch and 25 Chinese students are offered this scholarship by the ministries of education of both the countries. The STUNED Scholarship, it is valid for master studies, short courses, customized training programs, available for Indonesian professionals. So that's why it is available in the NAFIC NESO India. NAFIC NESO is like a official office between collaboration between different countries. So for India, you have another NAFIC NESO India. So it's only for Indonesians, the STUNED Scholarship. Next is the Desmond Ford Scholarship. So this one is for ambitious professionals in Asia, Africa, Latin America, Caribbean, Eastern Europe, Central Asia, who have a strong interest in green finance. So now, next we are moving on to the university-specific scholarships. So you can obviously have a look at the university websites to know about them, but I will quickly run through them because they have been grouped very nicely in a website called Scholars for DEF, which is like scholarship for developing countries. And you can subscribe to the newsletter also. They send very nice detailed links of scholarships that you can get. I did that during my master's to know about the different scholarship programs, and it's really helpful. So I can show you quickly the link. So in the Scholars for Dev, the developing countries, they have outlined like, but I would again recommend you to go to those university websites to know about the university specific scholarships. They have like partial and full scholarship. There are different schemes available. Just like you see, like Leiden University, they have some 10,000 euro tuition fees, you get scholarship, or maybe 15,000 euro or total fee minus. So you have to go to those universities or maybe click on these links and they will redirect you to, yeah. So they have also given a page, and I would highly recommend you to subscribe to the newsletter. It helps a lot. You can know about Europe, US, other countries also. So University of Maastricht, high potential scholarships, Radboud University scholarships. These are all the universities that are, most of them are part of the VSNU, which is the Dutch Study Association. I mentioned about the VSNU in my previous video. You can check it, where I mentioned about what international students who are incoming in 2020 to Netherlands can expect given the coronavirus situation that is happening around now. Utrecht University, because U is pronounced as U in Dutch. So Utrecht University Excellence Scholarship, around 11,000 euro. Tuition fee or living expenses. Erik Bloemink Scholarship at University of Groningen. That's pronounced like that. For master students, TU Delft Excellence Scholarship. It was there during our time also, but it's very difficult. During our time, it was only 16 students were awarded this Justice Louis Van Heffen Scholarship. That is a full scholarship. You also save some money if you can spend less on living. For master students, international master students, but it was like 2 per faculty. In our time, it was 16. You can check the website. What is it now? So in our EEMCS, we have electrical, mathematics, applied science, computer engineering, and it was really difficult to be among those 2. So you can imagine like the difficulty. So next one is the University of 20 Scholarships, University Amsterdam Fellowship Program, Amsterdam Excellence Scholarship. So most of these are full scholarships, but I would recommend you to check the university website that you are applying for to be sure. I will leave all the links in the description below again. Now let's move to the scholarship for Indians. So if you remember, I mentioned in the list of scholarship in the Study in Holland website that I showed you before in part one, which was more like there are some scholarships in that 8 or 9 which were valid for Indians, not all. So you have to go through part one to know that. So if you want to go to the Orange Tulip of India, so these are different scholarships, the Orange Knowledge and Orange Tulip. And if you want to go to the Orange Tulip Scholarship of India, then they have another website and they have detailed it so nicely. See how you can apply, what are the frequently asked questions, registration and selection, different universities, what are the qualifications for different universities to apply for that. So everything I think you will find it here. So let me go to the next scholarship. And apart from that, there are some additional scholarships that you can get as an Indian. So I will highlight that. So the additional scholarship that you can get, this one I knew about it, but I could not apply for it because I was already late. And if you know any other additional scholarships apart from the one that I'm going to mention now, then please leave it in the comments below so that I can pin it and help you out all, help all the Indians or any international scholarships that I missed out here. Please leave it in the comment section so that I can pin it and help you maybe from Indonesia, Africa, or so. The purpose of this video is to make you aware, spread the information. So don't forget to share the video, like the video, and subscribe to the channel. So this is last but not the least, the J&T Tata Endowment for the Higher Education of Indians. So this is like a loan scholarship. So they don't necessarily give you like a huge sum of money that you don't need to repay, which is like a gift, but rather they give you like, I'm not sure, you have to check the website. During our time, I remember it was like a very low interest or interest-free loan. So if you go to their website, then they say like the scholarship ranges between 1 lakh rupees to 10 lakh rupees, and all scholars may not get the maximum amount. And they have a lot of eligibility criteria, the interview process. It's a very competitive, detailed process. Everything is outlined here, and it's very reputed. I've heard people who cannot pay back the bank interest of very high 13%, 14% when they take education loan in India. This scholarship will be really, really helpful. And who knows, they might be interest free or pay some interest. So I hope you like this video, this short video where I covered three things. First, general scholarships that you can get to study or work in Netherlands. University specific scholarships, which you obviously need to go to the university. And the third was the exclusive scholarship for Indians. So don't forget to like this video, share this video, and subscribe to the channel to keep getting more videos on this. So till next video, I hope you take care of your health, spread positivity, be safe. Till next video, see you from Valkenburg, Netherlands. Bye.